Hey everyone, Andrew from Educate here, and today we're doing a beginner's Excel crash course in data cleaning. So, this video is going to be helpful if you're someone who has an upcoming Excel data cleaning job interview, or maybe you said in your resume that you've got mad Excel skills, but you really don't, and you're trying to find an easy way to upskill on YouTube. Well, either way, I got you covered. So this is what we're doing in today's video. First off, we'll answer why is data cleaning important? Then we'll clean a spreadsheet together using some common data cleaning techniques. And then finally, you can feel good going to your next job interview. All right, let's kick things off with why is data cleaning important? Well, when you're creating your own data, maybe you're tracking daily calorie intake or tracking daily spending, chances are you'll fill it in properly so that there's no blanks, no duplicates, and that the data is formatted properly, right? But sometimes when you download data from other people or other systems, you can get corrupted and bad data. There might be blank entries, duplicates, and incorrect formatting, like accidentally putting a dollar sign against calorie intake. And if you or data scientists or management have to use that data to generate insights, it's going to be inaccurate because the data was inaccurate in the first place. In other words, garbage in, garbage out. So if you want the most accurate insights to your data, you have to make sure it's as clean as possible. Think of yourself as the Excel data janitor. All right, so let's jump over to the computer and we'll clean a spreadsheet together. If you want to clean with me, download the stonks.csv file from the link on the screen now, which will also be in the video description below. So once we've downloaded that, let's open it up in Notepad to see what we're working with. And what we have here is some stock market data. And it looks like scrambled eggs, right? There's some words at the top, there's some dates, some company names, and a whole bunch of numbers. It's hard to read, but for now, what I want you to take note of is the commas that are in between each of the letters and numbers. That's what a CSV is, comma-separated values, so that when we import it into Excel, it'll split each of these values into their own column. CSV is a really common file format, and you'll come across it a lot when you're doing data cleaning. Now, don't close this file yet. I want you to keep it open in the background. So let's import this file into Excel by firing it up. So we'll go to the Start menu, type in Excel, and press Enter. We're greeted with the home screen, and we'll click Open on the left, and we'll browse to the location where we downloaded stonks.csv. If you don't see it, change the extension to All Files and open stonks.csv. We're now greeted with the Text Import Wizard, and that'll help us import our CSV into a spreadsheet. The first screen asks us to choose the file type that best describes our data, delimited or fixed width. So we'd choose delimited if the characters, such as commas or tabs, separate each field. Yep, that sounds like us, so we'll check that and click Next. In this screen, we have to select how our fields are delimited or separated, and that's by comma. So we'll untick Tab and select comma, and you can see the preview underneath is already separating our data by comma, which is pretty cool. So we'll click Next, leave everything as the general data format, and click Finish. And there you go. You can see that Excel has pretty much used the commas to separate the values into their own column. Pretty neat, right? If I compare that side by side to what we saw in Notepad, this in Excel is already so much easier to read. The only problem is our data is kind of truncated or cut short by the width of the column. So what we'll do is expand the column width where there's data in it. We'll hover over to the column A letter until it turns green and you get this downward facing arrow, and we'll click and hold the left mouse button and drag it all the way to column H. that selected columns A to H. Next, we'll hover in between one of the selected columns until you get this thinner looking cross with a two-way arrow, and I want you to double click. That expands all the columns into a width that lets you see the longest value in the column. So now we can see the dates, name, and everything else. Now, if you have a keen eye, you would have noticed that the name column here contains commas in it. But up until now, I've been telling you that Excel separates values by commas, so Facebook and Inc. should have been separated into their own columns, right? Well, if we look back at Notepad, you can see that the company name is actually wrapped around in double quotes. This is the trick you do when you need to include commas inside your values. You wrap it in double quotes so that it treats everything inside it as text and ignores the comma. Alright, now that we've got our data in, we're going to use the following cleaning techniques to get our dirty data looking like showroom condition again. We're going to learn how to quickly delete these blank rows, remove some duplicates, remove excess spaces and blanks in some text. We're going to replace values, so I've misspelled Tesla as Telsa. We're going to standardize text by capitalizing every letter, and we're going to standardize dates. I'm going to keep this on the side here, and we'll cross them off one by one as we clean the data. So let's start by deleting blank rows. We can see in the data here that we have two blank rows, and we could manually delete them by hovering over the row number that has the empty row until we get this thick black arrow pointing to the right, right-clicking and pressing delete, and that'll delete the rows. But if we had 10 blank rows, it would be really tedious to do them individually. And if we had 1,000 rows instead of the 35 in this list, we'd have to manually eyeball each row, which would lead to human error. So let's undo that delete by clicking the undo button at the top. And a faster and more effective way to delete blank rows in a dataset is to use the go to special feature in Excel. And we get there by going to the home tab, and under the editing group on the far right, we click find and select and select go to special. We'll select blanks and press OK. Wow, look at that. Excel has selected all the blank rows in the dataset for us, so we don't have to do it manually. Then all we have to do is press the delete button in the cells group, and just like that, our two rows have been deleted. So we can cross that off our cleaning to-do list. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling cleaner already. All right, next is removing duplicate rows. Now we're actually going to do this twice, and let me explain why. I've hidden two duplicates in here. The first one is at the top, and these two records look identical, but when we click in on them, we can see that the second row has some excess spaces which the first one doesn't, therefore technically making them different values. The other one I've hidden is smack bang in the middle right here in row 14 and 15, and the data looks identical, but there's some extra spacing in the name here, which technically again no longer makes them duplicates. So when we use remove duplicates, neither of these records will get removed. And to show you what I mean, first, I just want you to click anywhere within your dataset. So I'll click on cell A1, and remove duplicates can be found by going to the data tab, and it's smack bang in the middle here. We'll click remove duplicates, press OK, and as expected, those two records weren't removed, which means we need to do a little bit more cleaning to the dataset, so let's leave this step for last. The tip here is there's almost no point doing remove duplicates until you have a clean dataset. The next cleaning step on the list is removing excess spaces. So as you can see with the name column, we have the company name, but they're all kind of out of position. And that's because when we double click on it, we can see that these names have excess spaces around them. And if I check the CSV file with Notepad, you can see that, yep, that's really the case. So in order to remove excess spaces, let's create a new column to the right of column C by hovering over column D until it turns green and we get this downward facing arrow, and right click and select insert. In our new column, we're going to use the trim function to remove excess space. So to use a function, we go equals, trim, open bracket, and this little pop-up is telling us it wants a piece of text to trim, and that piece of text is next to us in cell C2. So we'll click on that, and every time we open a bracket, we have to close it, and then we'll press enter. And then we'll grab the bottom right corner of the cell where it's got that tiny little square, and we'll hover over it until we see this thin black cross, and then we'll double click it. And that will automatically populate the formula to every row underneath until it finds a blank row. Look at that, that's so tidy now. That's what I love to see. Now, one thing to note is if I delete the value in C2, it also disappears in D2 because the value in D2 is technically a formula and it's displaying the result of the formula and it's not actually storing the value. So if I actually delete this column, I'll be left with this reference error, meaning it can't find the text we actually want to trim. At the same time, I don't want to keep both columns. It's kind of redundant. So we'll undo that. Right click on column D, select copy, and we want to paste as values, which will overwrite the formula with the actual value. So you can see that this is no longer trim C2, it's now Facebook Inc. You can now delete column C by hovering over it, right clicking and pressing delete. We no longer need it, and we can now rename our new column back to name. So now that we've got excess spaces removed, let's move on to replacing values. Now at the bottom of our data, I've misspelled Tesla as Telsa, and we're going to correct that with the find and replace feature in Excel. So we'll go to the home tab, go back to find and select on the far right, and choose replace. And we have a new box that asks us which word we want to find, which is Telsa. And the word we want to replace it with is Tesla. We'll click replace all, and Excel tells us it's made 10 replacements. Awesome, that's the replace function. Now let's move on to capitalizing every word. Now ticker is just an abbreviation of the company name, and our data has it in lowercase here, uppercase here, proper case here, and everything else in between. Ticker symbols are usually represented in uppercase, so let's mass update these to uppercase in one go. Like we did with the name column, we'll start by creating a new column to the side of ticker, so that's right clicking on the cell next door to it and selecting insert. We'll then use another function called upper, so that's equals upper, open bracket, and again, it's asking for the text we want to convert to uppercase, which is cell B2. We'll click on B2, close the bracket, and press enter. We'll then click on cell C2 and hover to the bottom right corner of the cell where it's got that little square and until we get that thin black cross. Then we'll double click on it so it populates all the way down until it sees a blank row. Now, if you want everything in lowercase, you can use lower in here. And if you want everything in proper case, you can use proper. But for this example, we'll stick with upper. As mentioned, with the name column, we'll copy our new column and paste as values. Awesome, that's another data cleaning technique we can cross off our list. And we'll just tidy this up by typing ticker at the top and deleting column B. The last thing we have to talk about, and this is a really important one, standardizing dates. Now, most of the time, you get regular looking dates like this, and then sometimes you'll get dates in Excel that are these 5-digit numbers, like these 3 examples here. The 5-digit number is actually the number of days that have passed since the 1st of January 1900, so it's been 44,375 days since the 1st of January 1990. The easiest way to update dates is to select the entire column and change the number format to short date, which you can find in the Home tab and in this drop-down list in the number group. And there you go, our dates have been updated. Now, finally, coming back to remove duplicates. Now that we have a clean dataset, we can finally remove duplicates. So we'll click on a cell that has data, and we'll go back to the Data tab and click Remove Duplicates. We'll press OK, and awesome! Microsoft Excel has removed 2 duplicates for us. And that's that! We finally have a clean data set that we can use to get some accurate insights from. So that's an introduction to data cleaning with Microsoft Excel. When you get to millions and billions of records, data cleaning in an IT project can take the longest amount of time. So believe me when I say that it's a super important step. Remember, garbage in, garbage out if you don't clean it properly. That's it for this video. I hope you got something out of it and you're feeling more confident talking about data cleaning at your next job interview. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you want to see more content like this, please consider subscribing, and thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. See ya!